In a ghoulish country lies Starina Community Academy. Because it's a Christian school, we only have 6 children participating in injections. Next!
Hello there, it's time for another RJDG14 special, and this time it's called an Injection of Autumn. As you may remember, about a year ago I made and uploaded a video to YouTube, and it was sort of like a family life's up and downs cartoon, which has since evolved into life around Starina. And basically, its main character is Sean Deadtree, who has been given a makeover since last year. He's injected with a DTP vaccine, which is what I've been given earlier today, and he gets some slightly nasty side effects. But anyway, hopefully he won't have those side effects that he had. And I may be tempted to make a remake at some point of that, because I did get the vaccination program bit, or vaccination experience a bit off at that time. But anyway, as you can see, I was given 2 vaccines, 1 in each arm today. In this arm, it's Rivaxis, which is a DTP injection, and it doesn't hurt much at all. And this arm, it's Men-C1, it hurts slightly more, but not an awful lot. But anyway, I'll now show you in pictures sort of the injection experience in my cartoon format. So here I am at 11:20 awaiting to be let in to the hall, or new sports hall as everyone calls it at my school, and to be vaccinated at these stations. So once I'm let in, the nurse reads out the surnames, sort of in alphabetical by surname order, and Gawley, which is my surname, isn't that far down the alphabet, so probably about a quarter to a third of the way in, so I was a relatively early one to be called up. I was in the first lot to be called up, and so then she gives me a form. I hand that form to one of the nurses, who gives me my vaccination. She takes the form and has her equipment here, and tells me to relax my arm. So I roll my sleeve up and sort of look forward, or a slight angle, or away from the vaccine itself as she gives it. So she then gives it. So she says, "I'm now going to give you your vaccine." And I look away and like this. And she gives it. Okay, that's one done. Let me tick it. Yep, you've had Rivaxis. Now let's go on and do Nisvaxi. Nisvaxi and the Men-C booster hurt more of the two. And the DTP one just felt like a simple scratch. And the second one felt like a scratch, but also with some aching as it was injected. So it was a bit uncomfortable, but not nasty. Afterwards, some people were worse affected, some of them felt quite faint. One, two fainted, and the majority, like me, were fine. Obviously, I did feel a tiny bit dizzy for maybe 5 minutes or so afterwards. There's only one walking, though. But anyway, there's a lot of sweets, so I'm eating my sweet here. And me overall feels absolutely fine. And then I just go off back to my lesson. See, my arm does slake a little bit, especially this one. Less so this. This one's only ached a little bit today. This one's ached a bit today, but nothing worth crying about. Yeah, that's how I was injected. And there were also some rumours, some of which may be true, others are false about injections, but most of them are false, that I'd gone on about in the past. The first one is, do vaccinations lower children's IQs? Now, this is an ethical question that I've been talking about quite a lot over the last year or so, and I think the answer to that's no. I did an IQ test over the weekend, and I compared it with now, even the answers, questions were similar. Compared with now, and my score was similar to what it was a few days ago, so I don't think they really have much impact on IQs. My second question would be, do they cause infertility? It's not the HPV. I don't think it causes infertility. I could be wrong. These vaccines have been out long enough that they probably don't. So I'm guessing that's a no. Hopefully not. Otherwise, we won't have children when I'm older. And then the final thing would be, sort of, do they leave a scar? Well, I believe the answer is no. I can barely see a mark where they went in now. And from what I know, that mark will get even smaller over the next few days. So no, I don't think they do leave a scar. I did see some pictures of Rivaxis, sort of, reactions where they leave a slight mark, but mine's just a flat dot where the needle went in, like most people. And I didn't cry or really react about anything when it went in. I just sat back and relaxed, normal. And that's pretty much what it is from today's special. However, I can show you some stuff on RJDG14 online and my website to finish off. Okay, so we're... Okay, so we're now into RJDG14 online, and I've set up a new section of a website titled Ethics. If you click on it, it brings you lots of questions relating to the youth and other things. You can ask me something, you can browse the topics talked about, and see that. And there's also a bar up here which recently added stories. Currently there's only one about vaccinations. I haven't finished writing the article yet at the time of recording, although hopefully by the time of viewing this video I have finished writing the article. And that should confirm some of the rumours in there. And that's pretty much all it is for now. I'll see you in another video.